Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss previous year GATE question. Previous year GATE question number 14. Let us read the question. A 100 microampere ammeter has an internal resistance of 100 ohm. For extending its range to measure 500 microampere, the shunt required is of resistance. Okay, so very simple question actually they have asked. This is regarding the extension of range of ammeter. Okay, so it is given that Im is equal to 100 into 10 to the power minus 6 ampere. This is the Im. Okay, internal resistance Rm is equal to 100 ohm. Next, extending its range, so I is equal to 500 microampere. 500 into 10 to the power minus 6 ampere. Okay, next RSH we need to find. Okay, so can we find first multiplying power or multiplying factor? M is equal to I upon Im. So it is equal to 500 into 10 to the power minus 6 divided by Im is 100 into 10 to the power minus 6. Okay, so it is equal to 5. This is the M. Next, from this we can write RSH. Therefore, RSH is equal to Rm upon M minus 1. So, what is Rm? Rm is given. It is 100 ohm upon M minus 1. Right? So, 100 by 4. So, it is a 25 ohm. Okay? So, required RSH is of 25 ohm. Okay? Are you getting the point? Right? So friends, this is about the previous year GATE question number 14. This question is from GATE 2001 examination. Previous year GATE question number 15. Let us read the question. A moving coil of a meter has 100 turns and a length and depth of 10 mm and 20 mm respectively. It is positioned in a uniform radial flux density of 200 millitesla. The coil carries a current of 50 milliampere. The torque on the coil is, and here we are having the four options: 200 micro newton meter, 100 micro newton meter, 2 micro newton meter, and 1 micro newton meter. So very simple. We are having a PMMC instrument. As we know, in PMMC instrument, the torque, deflecting torque, is equal to NBI into A. Okay. So simple. Everything they have given. N is number of turns, it is 100. B is the flux density, it is a 200 millitesla. So it is 200 into 10 to the power minus 3 into current I is given 50 milliampere. 50 into 10 to the power minus 3 and into area. Area is, yes, length into depth. So it is a 10 into 10 to the power minus 3 into, I am writing here, 20 into 10 to the power minus 3. So if you check, if you simplify it, we will be getting it as a 200 micro newton meter. This is the deflecting torque, right? So if you check the options, correct option is option A. Okay, so friends, this is about the previous year GATE question number 15. Previous year GATE question number 16. Let us read the question. A moving iron ammeter produces a full scale torque of 240 micro newton meter with a deflection of 120 degree at a current of 10 ampere. The rate of change of self-inductance of the instrument at full scale is, okay, so we need to find the dl by d theta actually. It is given that td is equal to 240 into 10 to the power minus 6 newton meter. Okay, this is the td. Theta is given 120 degree. It is not required actually. Current I is 10 ampere. Okay, our task is to find dl by d theta. So as we know, in the MI instrument, TD is equal to half into I square into DL by D theta. Okay. So if you check, it is equal to 1 by 2 into I is given, current I is given, it is a 10 ampere. So it is a 10 square into DL by D theta. And what is TD? TD is 240 into 10 to the power minus 6. So if you simplify it, for dl by d theta, we will getting it as 4.8 micro newton meter per radian. This is the dl by d theta. Okay, very simple. Only thing is we need to recall the formula. Okay, so correct option is option B. So this is about the previous year gate question number 16. Previous year gate question number 17. Let us read the question. A current of minus 8 plus 6 root 2 into sine of omega t plus 30 degree ampere is passed through 3 meters. They are center 0 PMMC meter, true RMS meter and moving iron instrument. The respective reading in ampere will be. Okay, and they have given the four options. Okay, so we are having the current I is equal to minus 8 plus 6 root 2 into sine of omega t plus 30 degree. This is the current which is flowing. Okay, so let us consider this current as I1 and this part of the current as I2. First thing is they have given a center 0 PMMC meter. Center 0 means on the scale at the center point will be it will be having a 0 ampere notation. And if the pointer moves to the right hand side, it will show the positive reading. If the pointer will move at the left hand side, it will show the negative reading. Okay, so this meter will show positive as well as negative reading. Okay, so as we know, in the case of PMMC instrument, yes, it measures only average value. So what is the average value of current I? So therefore, reading of PMMC meter or the ammeter is equal to I average, which is equal to, yes, average value of this current. Okay, but what is the average value of sinusoidal term? It is a zero, so it is equal to minus 8 ampere only. So therefore reading is minus 8 ampere, right? Next, second is true RMS current. Okay, so therefore if you check, moving iron also measures the RMS value and the second meter is also true RMS meter. True RMS meter is the is nothing but it is given that the meter which measures the RMS value. Okay, so therefore reading of true RMS meter, which is again equal to reading of MI, reading of moving iron, right, MI instrument, okay, or MI ammeter, okay, which is equal to, and this is nothing but, yes, we can write it as I RMS, RMS value of the current I. So if you check, current I is having the two different combinations. One is the DC current and second one is the current I2, that is the sinusoidal. Okay, so we can write it as is equal to under root I1 RMS square plus I2 RMS square. So what is the I1 RMS? If you check, it is equal to under root I1 RMS is nothing but it is a DC only, so its RMS will be same, minus 8 square plus I2 RMS, it is a sinusoidal term I2, so it is a peak value divided by root 2, peak is 6 root 2. Okay, so we can write it as 6 root 2 divided by root 2 square. Okay, so if you check, it is equal to under root 8 square plus 6 square. Okay, so it is a 10 ampere. So point to be noted, the readings of the 3 meters are PMMC is showing minus 8, true RMS is showing 10 and MI is also showing 10, right? So it is minus 8, 10 and 10. So if you check the options, correct option is option C, right? So this is about the previous year gate question number 17. Previous year gate question number 18. Let us read the question. The DC current flowing in a circuit is measured by two ammeters. One is PMMC and the another one is electrodynamometer type, that is EDM, connected in series. The PMMC meter contains 100 turns in the coil. The flux density in the air gap is 0.2 Weber per meter square and the area of the coil is 80 millimeter square. The EDM ammeter has a change in mutual inductance with respect to deflection of 0.5 millihenry per degree. The spring constant of both the meters are equal. This is important. The value of current at which the deflection of 2 meters are same is, okay, So it is given that we are having the two ammeters connected in series. Okay, and our task is to find the value of current at which the deflections of 2 meters are same. Okay, so here it is given deflections of 2 meters are same. Okay, so can we write it as theta PMMC, that is the deflection of PMMC instrument, is equal to theta EDM, electrodynamometer type instrument. Okay, also it is given that the spring constants of 2 meters are same. Okay, also spring constants of 2 meters are also same. Okay, so therefore spring constants are same and theta are same. So can we write it as controlling torques, that is K into theta. Okay, so controlling torque of PMMC and controlling torque of EDM, right, both are same. Because wherever the spring constant is same as well as deflection is also same. Okay, so now we are having theta PMMC is equal to theta EDM. Okay, now how to find theta? Can we replace this theta with TD upon spring constant? Yes, and TD is equal to NBIE. Okay, I am writing it as TD in PMMC divided by spring constant KC, which is equal to TD in EDM divided by the spring constant. But spring constant are same in both the cases. Okay, so therefore it is a KC only. So this KC will get cancelled out. Okay, so TD PMMC should be equal to TD EDM. What is a TD PMMC? It is a NBIA, which is equal to TD EDM is half. It is I square into DM by D theta. I square into DM by D theta. Right? It is NBIA and this is I square into DM by D theta. Okay? So if you check, therefore we can write I is equal to, it is one I current will get cancelled out. Okay? So therefore it is equal to NBA divided by DM by D theta. DM by D theta. Okay? This is the current I. Okay? So further we can write it as, which is equal to, everything is given. Okay? So it is a N is 100. Okay, here we are having meter contains 100 tons, N is 100. Okay, flux density is 0.2 and area is 80 millimeter square. Okay, so we can write it as 100 into 80 into 10 to the power minus 6 into 0.2, right, divided by DM by D theta. It is a 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3, right? 0.5 millihenry it is given. Okay, so it is a 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3, right? So if you simplify it, you'll be getting it as 3.2 ampere. This is the current I, right? When this current flows through the circuit, then the deflections of both the meters will be same. Okay, so final answer is 3.2 ampere. So this is about the previous year gate question number 18. The previous year gate question number 19. Let us read the question. Two ammeters X and Y have resistances of 1.2 ohm and 1.5 ohm respectively, and they give full scale deflection with 150 milliampere and 250 milliampere respectively. Okay, so we are having the two ammeters, one is the X, second one is the Y. Okay, their internal resistances, that is the meter resistance, and their full scale deflection current they have given. The ranges have been extended by connecting shunts so as to give full scale deflection with 15 ampere. Okay, so extended range of both the ammeters is a 15 ampere. The ammeters along with shunts are connected in parallel and then placed in a circuit in which flowing current flowing is 15 ampere. Okay, so x and y we have connected in parallel. Okay, the current in ampere indicated in ammeter x is. Okay, this question is from GATE 2014 examination. So now here we need to understand where are the two ammeters, right? Their extended current range they have given, their basic current range, that is the IM as well as RM, they have given. Okay, so first thing is we need to find the shunt resistance for the ammeter X, shunt resistance for the ammeter Y, and after that we need to connect these two ammeters along with their shunt resistors in parallel. Okay, so and after that it is given that the total current in the flowing through the parallel combination is 15 ampere, and then our task is to find the current in the ammeter X. Okay, so first thing is let us first consider the ammeter X. Okay, so for ammeter X it is given that meter resistance RM is 1.2 ohm, right? And IM, that is a meter current, is equal to 150 milliampere, 150 into 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. Okay, extended range is 15 ampere, so I is equal to 15 ampere. So from this we can find the shunt resistance RSH, okay, which is equal to, we know it is RM upon M minus 1, right? Extension of range of ammeter we know. Okay, so it is equal to, M is nothing but I upon IM. Okay, so we can write it as RM upon I upon IM minus 1. Okay, so after this we need to put the values. What is RM? It is a 1.2 divided by I is 15 divided by IM is 150 into 10 to the power minus 3, right? Minus 1. So if you check, this will be equal to 0.012 ohm. Okay, so we will be having the ammeter X. Okay, it will be like this. This is the ideal meter, meter resistance, right? And across it we are having the shunt resistance. Okay, so it is given that meter current is 150 milliampere, RM is, it is given 1.2 ohm, and RSH just now we have calculated, it is 0.012 ohm. Okay, next, this current is, total current is 15 ampere. Okay, out of that here it is going 150 milliampere. Okay, this is the ammeter X. Okay, ammeter X. Next, now similarly we need to find for ammeter Y. I am writing here ammeter Y. So if you check for ammeter Y, it is given that meter resistance is 1.5 ohm, meter current, that is a full scale deflection current, is 250 milliampere, 250 into 10 to the power minus 3. Okay, so it is a 250 milliampere. Okay, next, what is the extended range current? I is, again, it is a 15 ampere. So again we can find the RSH, which is equal to RM upon M minus 1, and M is nothing but I upon IM. So we can write it as IM, RM upon I upon IM minus 1. Okay, so here we can put the values. It is a 1.5 divided by, yes, I upon IM. So it is a 15 upon IM is 250 into 10 to the power minus 3. Okay, minus 1. So if you check, this will be equal to 0.015 ohm. Okay, this is a RSH for meter Y. Okay, so we'll be having a meter Y. It is like a meter Y. It is like we're having a ideal meter, meter resistance, and here shunt resistance. Shunt resistance is 0.015 ohm. Okay, meter resistance is 1.5 ohm. Okay, and current is given for the meter Y. It is 250 milliampere. So it is 250 × 10⁻³ ampere. Okay, and this current is 15 ampere. Okay, this current is nothing but your IM, right? So this is the ammeter Y we are having. Next, now we need to connect these two meters in parallel. So two ammeters are in parallel. It is simply like a network analysis problem. Two ammeters are in parallel. Okay, so when two ammeters are connected in parallel, yes, the equivalent circuit will be like this. Ammeter X, internal resistance of ammeter X, shunt resistance of ammeter X, right? Similarly, we are having second meter, that is the ammeter Y. This is the ammeter Y, internal resistance of ammeter Y, and shunt resistance of ammeter Y. Okay, these two are connected in parallel. Correct. So this is 1.2 ohm. This current is X, meter X current we need to find. Okay, so meter X current, suppose this is the X meter or X ammeter, okay, and RSS is given 0.012 ohm. okay, this is the, we are having Y meter, its internal resistance is 1.5 ohm, and here it is 0.015 ohm. okay, next, this current total, it is given 15 ampere. Suppose this current is Ix, this current is Iy. Our task is to find the Ix actually. Okay, current flowing through the meter X. So now how to simplify this circuit? Yes, so here if you check, this is the ideal meter, so it does, it will not be having any resistance. So it is like these two are in connected in parallel, these two are connected in parallel. Okay, so further we can find 1.2 in parallel with 0.012 and 1.5 in parallel with 0.015. okay, and we can replace these two branches with a single resistor, these two branches with a single resistor. Okay, so further we can write the simplified structure. It will be like this. So here we will be having only one resistor. Okay, and here the second resistor. This total current is 15 ampere. Current here is Ix. Current here is Iy. Okay, and this resistance will be, yes, this resistance is nothing but 1.2 in parallel with 0.012. So I am writing here 1.2 in parallel with 0.012. okay, so if you check 1.2 in parallel with 0.012, okay, it will be like 1.2 into 0.012 upon 1.2 plus 0.012. So it will be 0.0118 ohm. Similarly, we can find parallel combination of these two. This can be replaced with a single resistor. So it is like 1.5 in parallel with 0.015. Okay, so if you check, it is equal to 0.0245. Okay, so now by using the current division rule, we can find Ix. Okay, so using current division rule, we can write, using current division rule,
Yes. IX or small IX we can write. Is equal to total current 15 into value of resistance in the opposite branch, that is a 0.0245 divided by addition of these two, 0.0118 plus 0.0245. Okay, so if you check, it is equal to 10.1 ampere. Okay, 10.1 ampere. So the reading of ammeter X is 10.1 ampere, right? So friends, this is about the previous year GATE question number 19. This question is from GATE 2014 examination. Thank you.